In the previous video, we introduced the concepts of elements, which are one of the biggest parts of Polymer, and we looked at how we can actually import individual elements into a web page, specifically an input element. In this video, we're going to expand our understanding of elements by building a very simple web page. The web page that we're going to create will be a web page dedicated to the very first video in this series. It's obviously not a very real world idea, but it will help us demonstrate the ways that different components can work together. Because a YouTube video is going to be the center of attention for this page, we're actually going to use one of the Google web components, specifically the Google YouTube web component. You could of course download this from here, but because I'm using Bower as a package manager for this project, you can use the GitHub Google web components repositories. And we can download the Google Web Components all through this single download link, which are Google Web Components. So to download and install all of the packages that we're going to need, we're just going to type bower install Google Web Components / Google Web Components. And we're also going to have the save flag. And this will download all of the components onto our local machine so that we can use them. And if we look in the Bower Components folder, we can see that we have access to all of these different components, all from our local machine. I've gone ahead and created an empty page for us to use for this example, which at the moment simply imports the Web Components JS library, as well as Polymer itself. Now at the moment our web page is just a blank white screen, and so the first thing that we can do is to add a panel which we can use to contain the content that we're going to add. So I'm just going to copy and paste this link, and we're going to use the paper header panel element. And once we've imported that, we can obviously go ahead and use it, just as though it was any other element. Now in and of itself, the paper header panel doesn't actually do much for us. It's just an empty div essentially. But what it does do is it allows us to add new elements. So if we add a paper toolbar, which we will also need to import, and we can actually go ahead and add in a title for our page here. So we're going to use example Polymer project. So if we save that page and head back to our browser and refresh, we can see that we have this element, although our content isn't displaying as we would expect it to. And that's simply because the content should be wrapped inside of a div. So if we head back across to the page and wrap the content of the title itself in a div, and then head back across to our page and refresh again, we can see that we have the actual example Polymer project title displaying in our page. So now that we have our header panel in place, we can go ahead and create some sort of content to display within this section. Now to help us actually lay out our page in a consistent way, we're actually going to add some properties to the body of this page. Specifically, we're going to add vertical and layout, and these are going to be classes. If we refresh the page, we're not actually going to see any difference at the moment, but by having this standardized classes, it will allow Polymer to be more consistent across different devices. So now that we have our header panel in place, we can add some content to it. We obviously have our paper toolbar, which is displaying our title, but we can go ahead and add some other content. So if we use paper material, we can actually go ahead and create something that looks quite good. And we obviously need to import this again. So refreshing the page now, but it will create this element which has shadows already applied to it. And because again it is inside of the header element, it is all in line with the header element. We could of course resize the header element to be 50% of the page width, for example, and everything inside of it will automatically adjust accordingly. Instead of just displaying this content as displayed, however, this could be the header for our video. And if we are going to use this as the header for our video, the next logical step would be to include the video itself. Again, because we've already imported this, we can simply use the same construct to refer to the Google YouTube element. And once we've imported the Google YouTube element, it's simply a matter of using it. Now, we actually need to pass some parameters across to make sure that we're using the correct video. And as you would expect with a custom element, the parameters are also customized. And so we can simply pass across the video ID, as well as some other things, for example, the height. We'll just do 720 pixels, as well as the width. And we're going to turn off autoplay. So if you go back across to our browser now, we can see how this is looking. And if we refresh the page, you can see that our video is automatically being imported. We've not had to mess around with the YouTube API or create an iframe or anything else. This is automatically handled for us. Now if we look at this, however, we would really want to see the video inside of this element after the title itself. So let's see how we can do that. Because we've closed the paper material element here, this has applied the shadow at the end of that element. And so it's simply a matter of moving this to beyond the point where we want everything to include. So the YouTube element now is included within the paper material element. Just as if the paper material element was just any other div that you have been working with in the past. Now we also want to make the heading stand out, so I'm just going to add a header 3 here, just so it actually looks like a header. And after the video itself, we may want some other text. If we refresh our page now, we can see that this looks like a single element. And we can of course do other things to make this element stand out more. For example, we can change the background colour of the body. So I'm just going to do that in line here. And if we refresh again, we're going to see that the background colour has changed to grey. But we need to then reapply the white to the element itself that we want it to actually remain white. And as you can see, that now shows up a lot more clearly. Now you may also notice that this white element is now separated from the blue header, so we can go ahead and fix that as well, which is simply a matter of moving the paper element to starting before the actual header element. Like so. And if we refresh again, we can see that we have the page exactly as we would expect to see it. Now this is by no means the best page in the world, but it does give you some idea of how you can use elements and how similar they are to ordinary div tags which you may be more familiar with, as well as some of the more complex functionality available with some of the other more complex elements. And we've obviously covered quite a lot of different topics within this video. But hopefully by giving you an example of how you can create quite complex functionality very easily, you will have some sort of reference point so that when we're talking about the specific features later on, you'll be able to relate to how they actually are used. In the next video, we're going to be looking at the layout elements within Polymer. For example, how I've used vertical and layout here, as well as how we've used the header panel as our actual construction, which is holding everything together. There are a couple of other ways that we can lay out pages within Polymer, and we'll talk about those as well. So make sure you subscribe so you don't miss that.